An application with a clean and intuitive UI is a factor that makes an application great. In Tizen, UI can be achieved using the open-sourced EFL. Hi, I'm Vincent, and in this episode, I'll introduce you to EFL and how you can use it to create UI for your Tizen applications. The Enlightenment Foundation Libraries, or EFL, is an open-source collection of libraries consisting of various utilities and applications. The API being written in C, and EFL being built for performance. EFL is now being used to create Tizen native applications. Currently, there are 5 types of EFL available to Tizen. These are Ecore, Edge, Eina, Elementary, and Evas. These libraries provide data structures, optimized rendering, thread pool, events and callbacks, FD handlers, timers and animators, widgets, and layout scripts to the Tizen platform. We'll talk more about these libraries in the next section. EFL is widely used not only in mobile platforms, it makes application portable into different types of devices. The following are the key characteristics of EFL. Performance. EFL is optimized and is fast in software rendering. It is said that this is one of the reasons why Tizen chose EFL as its native toolkit. Small memory footprint. EFL applications are great for low memory devices. Backend engine support. It enables the application to bypass dealing with backend engines separately. GUI and logic separation. The layout description can be saved in a text file while the logic can be implemented in C. It's themable. Widgets are customizable and changing a theme does not need restarting the application. Scalable. It configures the scale factor. With that, applications can scale nicely. Animations. It supports APIs for different types of animations. And finally, hardware acceleration. It supports OpenGL and OpenGL ES acceleration. Early on, we mentioned that EFL has 5 different types of libraries, and they are all supported by Tizen: Ecore, Edge, Eina, Elementary, and Evas. Let's get into them individually in detail. The Ecore has modules for operating system abstraction and integration. It runs infinitely in loop and handles all registered events such as touch, mouse, key, and the like. Edge is a graphical design and layout library. It was designed to separate the layout and logic in applications. Eina is a data type library and other useful tools. It provides lists, iterators, arrays, hash tables, and many other data models. Elementary is a library that provides widgets. It's used to create basic UI widgets such as buttons, checkboxes, and windows. Evas is an animation, highly optimized scene graph and rendering library. It is basically a canvas in which you create scenes and manipulate their states. In creating Tizen apps with EFL, there is what you call base layout and widget hierarchy. The window is where the widget UI is rendered in an application. The conformant supports the indicator and is responsible for resizing the application when the device rotates. The Navi frame manages a view and also provides the title of the screen. It's used to make screen transitions by changing its view area. Here are some of the sample applications and their base layout wireframes. The settings application has a gen list inside its Navi frame that produces the list we use in changing the settings of our device. Next is the App Store application. Inside the Navi frame is a scroller. Then inside it is a box widget. Several widgets can be nested to produce a complex layout. Optionally, you can remove the Navi frame, especially for applications not requiring screen transitions. Take the calculator app for example. Container widgets are sufficient enough for its layout. To create your EFL Tizen app, please prepare the following: a Tizen IDE. You can download it from developer.tizen.org. The application that we'll create is an introductory app for using EFL. So to start, go to the Tizen IDE and create a new Tizen native project. Choose UI application, then basic UI application. Let's provide a name for the project, then click on finish. Go to the C file inside the SRC folder of the application, then take a look inside the file. The structure app data on the top is a pointer to important objects in our application. As you can see, it has the pointer to the window, conformant, and a label. The window and conformant are the basic objects that are needed to create a base layout. Next are a couple of callbacks for application termination and application flow and event control. On the main function, the app data pointer is created and initialized. Also, event handlers are initialized to listen app core related callbacks. Next up is a create base GUI function. In here, we create and initialize our GUI objects. It is marked as static because it is only reachable from the current compilation unit. This ensures a smaller code and faster production of the compiler. The NaviFrame is useful for applications showing multiple screens. Let's create a NaviFrame for our application. First, we create an element of NaviFrame inside our app data. Then, on the create base GUI function, we use elementary NaviFrame add and input the conformant as an argument. Use the function elementary object content set to add the NaviFrame to the conformant. Next, we're going to create a box widget using elementary box add, then input the NaviFrame. Set the box vertical by using elementary box horizontal set and also using Eina false. Make the box expandable when the contents need more space by using size hint weight set. Also, make the box fill the available space using the size hint align set. After that, let's add the box in the NaviFrame container by using elementary NaviFrame item push. Let's add the NaviFrame object, title, previous and next button as null, the objects to be pushed, and item style as null. Show the box using Evas object show function. Let's add the label to the box by using the same procedure we did to the box widget. Let's place it in the middle by using a 0.5 instead of Eva's hint fill. Now, to set the text of the label, use elementary object text set. Then, pack the label inside the box using elementary box pack end. Then show the label object using Evas object show. After that, let's experiment with buttons. Let's create a button that will induce a screen transition. First, let's use elementary button add to initialize a button. Then we set the weight and alignment hint of the button. With Eva's object smart callback add function, we can provide a callback for the button that will be like an on-click listener. The arguments needed are the button, the event in our sample app it's clicked, the function to be called, and a user data. For our user data, let's use the app data add. Let's go ahead and create the callback. Now, inside the callback, we use the user data app data to point to our nav frame, and then we update it by recreating the contents. Now, this time, we change the header and create a background of different color. We're done. Let's test it out in our emulator. So, here is the first screen we made. We can see the label and the button. Let's go ahead and click the button. The button enables the screen transition from the first page to the second. Now, if you want to learn more about EFL, you can also check out their API guide on developer.tizen.org. Let's go ahead and sum up this episode. EFL is composed of various components. Go ahead and familiarize yourself with them so that you may use it wisely on your applications. Always use the layout that matches your application needs. And finally, there is an API guide to help you in creating your EFL applications. You can browse it at the Tizen developer site. That's it for Tizen EFL Basics. If you have any inquiries, go to, register, or log in to developer.samson.com and developer.tizen.org. Also, don't forget to give a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to the Samson Developers channel. Thanks for watching.